back to the most extreme ship shoots, one of the most important ones that that you'll see up the exhibit upstairs, of which we're going to go up there shortly, it was taken from Fort Wadsworth. But now that's an example, because like when you take a subject of something at the same time. Queen Mary 2 is a beautiful ship, but the one thing is that when the picture got featured in Cruise Travel magazine, they liked the lighting of it. Because there was two types of pictures. I had one at sunset, I had one where it's just a golden sun, one was just like a hue blue, and the other one was just a bright sun. But they liked the other one because of the detail it showed. That's to show you the importance of it, because like when people go out and take pictures, it's like they don't really like show the love of it, they don't look at the minute differences. And that's one thing that I spent many months and years practicing, and I really worked hard at it. If you're going to go out and take a picture, if you're going to do something, it has to just, it's got to be perfect. It's got to be just majestic. It's got to be great. Great. And I even had the honor of Mickey Arison, when he shared my photograph of Queen Victoria passing the World Trade Center at the Cunard Line. In that case, she made a very rare, she never comes to New York. Usually the other two queens, Queen Elizabeth and Queen Victoria, usually in the UK, but the Queen Mary too, she usually sails back and forth. Question?
Yeah, what I'm interested in is how you got involved so passionately with this idea about taking photographs of ships. How did that begin for you?
It began for me because of, I looked in Maritime Magazine after I did my thing with the QE2. I said to myself, there's not a lot of people out here really documenting these things. Nobody's really out there, because Steamboat Bill, I can think of Steamboat, certain cruise magazines, I noticed they were not really on the 8-ball with certain things that I deemed still existed. They weren't on the 8-ball, they weren't constantly uploading things. A lot of pictures just standard, so I said, if no one else is gonna go out there, I gotta go out there and do it. And it's just, I took it upon myself. It was just something that I had to do, because I said, you know, it's just something I have to do. It's for the sake of history, because I want people to look back on it. I can say that it's been a wild ride. It's been quite an adventure. One of the missions that does stand out to me, speaking of Navy, was when I documented the USS Enterprise decommissioning. She was down in Norfolk in 2012 at her inactivation ceremony. First nuclear carrier built, 50 years of service. And I was very honored to do it because of the fact that the history behind the ship, so many thousands of people worked on it, and I was there to document it. And to this day, I've had over 40,000 views on YouTube of my two videos. I've had veterans, I've had people who worked the ship, family members, people who worked on the ship. It's just that thing, and they've always thanked me for taking that footage of the family. That's something that I'm honored to do, and it's a continuing mission, because when I'm long gone, I want, you know, the younger generation to do right by me and to carry on the tradition, because I don't feel this is something that should die, because I took on the mantle of responsibility, so that way it doesn't become a dying art. I shouldn't be the last of the Mohicans. I should be the first of something new, and I hope that I inspire more young people to go out and do something progressive, because that's what I did. It was something I just wanted to do because, you know, I enjoyed it. This big event in New York City, I call it the Grand Fleet. It was a massive amount of five crew members coming to New York. It also was very historical because the Queen Mary 2 never docks in Manhattan. She always docks in Brooklyn. But it was also the first time she passed the new World Trade Center where it was completed. So we had an armada of five ships. I got up at 3 o'clock in the morning, got to Jersey City Exchange at 5 a.m. on the dot. I look at my watch, I said, where are they? It's pitch black. I see a ship coming on, and then I see them all lit up like Christmas trees in the distance. I said, there they are. And then I got my camera set, I looked through the viewfinder. I said, what's going on? The Royal Princess took the lead right to Brooklyn, turned 180 degrees, docked. Jen came in, zipped first, and it was Carnival Splendor that came in. and then Queen, then I said Queen Mary II, just coming and sailing as the sun was coming up. Then she just gracefully passed the World Trade Center, thus uniting the Trinity, the first time they both had met. And then she passed the Empire State Building and sailed right into the pier there as the splendor was pulling in. And it was just a beautiful sight to behold. Just the watcher come in like that. And then we had the Isle of Luna come in as the sun fully rose. And then I took my bike up to Weehawken, where they were all lined up like, just like old luxury liner row. It was just all lined up, and I just snapped away. And it was just so beautiful just to see them all decked up like that. And I gotta say, that was just a really spectacular moment. It was just, it's the first time it ever happened, and it won't happen again, not for a while. And that picture's been used in the New York Cruise website. It's been shared many times and acknowledged and featured in Power Ships magazine. It was also featured in the book by one of my colleagues, John Fostick.